name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. He who shut in the depths is beheld dead, wrapped in fine linen and spices. The immortal one is laid in a tomb as a mortal man. The women have come to anoint him with myrrh, weeping bitterly and crying, this is the most blessed Sabbath on which Christ has fallen asleep to rise on the third day. Lord of mercy, 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 Lord have 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 mercy. O most holy Trinity, might in one essence, kingdom undivided, the cause of all good. Have mercy even on me, a sinner, confirm and instruct my heart, and take away from me every defilement, enlighten my mind, that I may ever glorify, praise, and adore thee, saying, one is holy, one is Lord Jesus Christ, the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Wisdom.
Just truly need to bless you, O Theotokos, ever blessed and most pure in the Mother of our God.
Most holy Theotokos, save us.
For honor of all and the cherubim, and more glorious the defilement, you gave birth to God the Word, true Theotokos, we magnify you.
Glory to thee, O Christ, our God and our hope, glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. In the name of the Lord, Father, give the blessing.
May he who rose from the dead, Christ our true God, through the prayers of his most pure mother, of the holy, glorious, and all audible apostles, of our Father among the saints, Basil the Great, whose liturgy we will celebrate today, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is good and loves mankind. Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Chambers on the waters, who makest the clouds thy chariot, who ridest on the wings of the wind, who makest the wind thy messengers, fire and flame thy ministers. Thou didst set the earth on its foundation, so that it should never be shaken. Thou didst cover it with the deep as with the garment. The waters stood above the mountains. At thy rebuke they fled. At the sound of thy thunder they took to flight. The mountains rose, the valleys sank down to the place which thou didst appoint for them. Thou didst set a bound which they should not pass, so that they might not again cover the earth. Thou makest springs gush forth in the valleys, they flow between the hills, they give drink to every beast of the field, the wild asses quench their thirst. By them the birds of the air have their habitation, they sing among the branches. From thy lofty abode thou waterest the mountains, the earth is satisfied with the fruit of thy work. Thou dost cause the grass to grow for the cattle, and plants for man to cultivate, that he may bring forth fruit from the earth, and wine to gladden the heart of man, oil to make his face shine, and bread to strengthen man's heart. The trees of the Lord are watered abundantly, the cedars of Lebanon which he planted. In them the birds build their nests, the stork has her home in the fir trees. The high mountains are for the wild goats, the rocks are a refuge for the badgers. Thou hast made the moon to mark the seasons. The sun knows its time for setting. Thou makest darkness, and it is night, when all the beasts of the forest creep forth. The young lions roar for their prey, seeking their food from God. When the sun rises, they get them away and lie down in their dens. Man goes forth to his work and to his labor until the evening. O Lord, how manifold are thy works! In wisdom hast thou made them all. The earth is full of thy creatures. Yonder is a sea, great and wide, which teems with things innumerable, living things both small and great. There go the ships, and Leviathan, which thou didst form to sport in it. These all look to thee, to give them their food in due season. When thou givest to them, they gather it up. When thou openest thy hand, they are filled with good things. When thou hidest thy face, thou art dismayed. When thou takest away their breath, they die and return to their dust. When thou sendest forth thy spirit, they are created, and thou renewest the face of the ground. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in his works. Who looks on the earth and it trembles, who touches the mountains and they smoke. I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will sing praise to my God while I have being. May my meditation be pleasing to him, for I will rejoice in the Lord. Let sinners be consumed from the earth, let the wicked be no more. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Praise the Lord. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God.
In peace let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Metropolitan Tikhon, for our Archbishop Nathaniel, for the honorable priesthood, the diaconate of Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this country, its president, for all civil authorities and for the armed forces, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Abbess Mother Christophora and for all the sisters of this holy monastery, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city and countryside, and for the faithful dwelling in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For seasonable weather, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by land, by sea, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, let us pray to the Lord. We may be delivered from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Commemorating our most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos and our Virgin Mary, the Father of the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God. For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
God bless the sun of day. This is the blessed.
angels the beauty of the faithful. She was born of man, yet gave birth to God. She was revealed as the heaven, as the temple of the garden. She destroyed the wall of enmity. She commands the peace. She opened the kingdom. Since she is our foundation of faith, our defender is the Lord whom she bore. Courage, courage, O people of God, for Christ will destroy our enemies, since he is all of God.
Wisdom, stand right.
God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning one day. And God said, let there be a firmament in the midst of the waters. Let it separate the waters from the waters. And God made the firmament and separated the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which were above the firmament. And it was so. And God called the firmament heaven, and there was evening, and there was morning a second day. And God said, let the waters under the heavens be gathered together into one place, and let the dry land appear. And it was so. And God called the dry land earth, and the waters that were gathered together he called seas. And God saw that it was good. And God said, let the earth put forth vegetation, plants yielding seed, and fruit trees bearing fruit, in which is their seed, each according to its kind, upon the earth. And it was so. And God brought forth vegetation, plants yielding seed according to their own kinds, and trees bearing fruit, in which is their seed, each according to its kind. And God saw that it was good, and there was evening, and there was morning a third day.
Wisdom.
The readings from the prophecy of Isaiah.
Let us attend.
Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For behold, darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the peoples. But the Lord will arise upon you, and his glory will be seen upon you. And nations will come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your rising. Lift up your eyes about and see. They all gather together. They come to you. Your sons shall come from far. Your daughters shall be carried in the arms. Then you shall see and be radiant. Your heart shall thrill and rejoice, because the abundance of the sea shall be turned to you. The wealth of the nation shall come to you. A multitude of camels shall cover you, and the young camels of Midian and Ephah, all those from Sheba shall come. They shall bring gold and frankincense and shall proclaim the praise of the Lord. All the flocks of Kedar shall be gathered to you. The rams of Nebaioth shall minister to you. They shall come up with acceptance upon my altar, and I will glorify my glorious house. Who are these that fly like a cloud and like doves to their windows? For the coastlands shall wait for me, the ships of Tarshish first, to bring your sons from far, their silver and gold with them, for the name of the Lord your God and for the Holy One of Israel, because he has glorified you. Foreigners shall build up your walls, and their kings shall minister to you. For in my wrath I smote you, but in my favor I have had mercy on you. Your gates shall be open continually, day and night they shall not be shut, that men may bring to you the wealth of the nations, with their kings led in procession. For the nation and kingdom that will not serve you shall perish. Those nations shall be utterly laid waste. The glory of Lebanon shall come to you, the cypress, the plane, and the pine, to beautify the place of my sanctuary. And I will make the place of my feet glorious. The sons of those who oppressed you shall come bending low to you, and all who despised you shall bow down at your feet. They shall come, they shall call you the city of the Lord, the Zion, the Holy One of Israel. Whereas you have been forsaken and hated, with no one passing through, I will make you majestic. I will make you majestic forever, a joy from age to age. You shall suck the milk of nations, you shall suck the breast of the kings, and you shall know that I, the Lord, am your Savior, your Redeemer, the Mighty One of Israel.
Wisdom.
Reading from Exodus.
Blessed.
The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, this month shall be for you the beginning of months. It shall be the first month of the year for you. Tell all the congregation of Israel that on the 10th day of this month they shall take every man a lamb according to their father's houses, a lamb for the household, and if the household is too small for a lamb, then a man and his neighbor next to his house shall take according to the number of persons, according to what each can eat, you shall make your count for the lamb. Your lamb shall be without blemish, a male year old. You shall take it from the sheep or from the goats, and you shall keep it until the 14th day of this month, when the whole assembly of the congregation of Israel shall kill their lambs in the evening. Then they shall take some blood and put it on the two doorposts and the lintel of the houses in which they eat them. They shall eat the flesh that night, roasted with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. They shall eat it. Do not eat any of it raw or boiled with water, but roasted its head with its legs and its inner parts. And you shall let none of them remain until the morning. Anything that remains until the morning you shall burn. In this manner you shall eat it, your loins girded, your sandals on your feet, and your staff in your hand. And you shall eat it in haste. It is the Lord's Pascha.
Wisdom.
The reading is from the prophecy of Jonah. Now the word of the Lord came to Jonah, the son of Amittai, saying, Arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and cry against it, for their wickedness has come up before me. But Jonah rose to flee to Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. He went down to Joppa and found a ship going to Tarshish. So he paid the fare and went on board to go with them to Tarshish, away from the presence of the Lord. But the Lord hurled a great wind upon the sea, and there was a mighty tempest on the sea, so that the ship threatened to break up. Then the mariners were afraid, and each cried to his God, and they threw the wares that were in the ship into the sea, to lighten it for them. But Jonah had gone down into the inner part of the ship, and had lain down, and was fast asleep. So the captain came and said to him, What do you mean, you sleeper? Arise, call upon your God. Perhaps God will save us, that we do not perish. And they said to one another, Come, let us cast lots, that we may know on whose account this evil has come upon us. So they cast lots, and the lot fell upon Jonah. Then they said to him, Tell us on whose account this evil has come upon us. What is your occupation, and whence do you come? What is your country, and of what people are you? And he said to them, I am a Hebrew, and I fear the Lord, the God of heaven, who made the sea and the dry land. Then the men were exceedingly afraid, and he said to him, What is this that you have done? For the men knew that he was fleeing from the presence of the Lord, because he had told them. Then they said to him, What shall we do to you, that the sea may quiet down for us? The sea grew more and more tempestuous. He said to them, Take me up and throw me into the sea, then the sea will quiet down for you. For I know it is because of me that this great tempest has come upon you. Nevertheless, the men rowed hard to bring the ship back to land, but they could not, for the sea grew more and more tempestuous against them. Therefore they cried to the Lord, We beseech thee, O Lord, let us not perish for this man's life, and lay not on us innocent blood, for thou, O Lord, hast done as it pleased thee. So they took up Jonah and threw him into the sea, and the sea ceased from its raging. Then the men feared the Lord exceedingly, and they offered a sacrifice to the Lord and made vows. And the Lord appointed a great whale to swallow up Jonah, and Jonah was in the belly of the whale 3 days and 3 nights. Then Jonah prayed to the Lord his God from the belly of the whale, saying, I called to the Lord out of my distress, and he answered me. Out of the belly of Sheol I cried, and thou didst hear my voice, for thou didst cast me into the deep, into the heart of the seas. And the flood was round about me, all thy waves and thy billows passed over me. Then I said, I am cast out from thy presence, how shall I again look upon thy holy temple? The waters closed in over me, the deep was round about me, weeds were wrapped about my head at the roots of the mountains. I went down to the land, whose bars closed upon me forever. Yet thou didst bring up my life from the pit, O Lord my God. When my soul fainted within me, I remembered the Lord, and my prayer came to me in thy holy temple. Those who pay regard to thine idols forsake their true loyalty, but I with the voice of thanksgiving will sacrifice to thee. What I have vowed I will pay, deliverance belongs to the Lord. And the Lord spoke to the whale, and it cast out Jonah upon the dry land. Then the word of the Lord came to Jonah the second time, saying, Arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and proclaim to it the message that I tell you. So Jonah arose and went to Nineveh according to the word of the Lord. Now Nineveh was an exceedingly great city, 3 days' journey in breadth. Jonah began to go into the city, going a day's journey. And he cried, Yet 40 days and Nineveh shall be overthrown. And the people of Nineveh believed God. They proclaimed a fast and put on sackcloth from the greatest of them to the least of them. Then tidings reached the king of Nineveh, and he arose from his throne, removed his robe, and covered himself with sackcloth, and sat in ashes. And he made proclamation and published through Nineveh, By the decree of the king and his nobles, let neither man nor beast, herd nor flock, taste anything. Let them not feed or drink water, but let man and beast be covered with sackcloth, and let them cry mightily to God. Yea, let everyone turn from his evil way and from the violence which is in his hands. Who knows, God may yet repent and turn from his fierce anger, so that we perish not. When God saw what they did, how they turned from their evil way, God repented of the evil which he had said he would do to them, and he did not do it. But it displeased Jonah exceedingly, and he was troubled, and he prayed to the Lord and said, I pray thee, Lord, is not this what I said when I was yet in my country? That is why I made haste to flee to Tarshish, for I knew that thou art a gracious God and merciful, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love, and repentest of evil. Therefore now, O Lord, take my life from me, I beseech you, for it is better for me to die than to live. And the Lord said, Do you do well to be angry? Then Jonah went out of the city and sat on the east of the city, and made a booth for himself there. He sat under it in the shade, till he should see what would come of the city. And the Lord God appointed a plant and made it come up over Jonah, that it might be a shade over his head, to save him from his discomfort. So Jonah was exceedingly glad because of the plant. But when dawn came up the next day, God appointed a worm which attacked the plant, so that it withered. When the sun rose, God appointed a sultry east wind, and the sun beat upon the head of Jonah, so that he was faint. And he asked that he might die, and said, It is better for me to die than to live. But God said to Jonah, Do you do well to be angry for the plant? And he said, I do well to be angry enough to die. And the Lord said, You pity the plant for which you did not labor, nor did you make it grow, which came into being in a night and perished in a night. And should not I pity Nineveh, that great city in which there are more than 120,000 persons who do not know their right hand from their left, and also much cattle?
Wisdom.
The reading is from Joshua.
Let us attend.
While the people of Israel were encamped in Gilgal, they kept the Passover on the 14th day of the month, at evening in the plains of Jericho. And on the morrow after the Passover, on that very day, they ate of the produce of the land, unleavened cakes and parched grain. And the manna ceased on the morrow, when they ate of the produce of the land. And the people of Israel had manna no more, but ate of the fruit of the land of the Phoenicians that year. When Joshua was by Jericho, he lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, a man stood before him with his drawn sword in his hand. And Joshua went to him and said to him, Are you for us or for our adversaries? And he said, No, but as a commander of the army of the Lord, I have now come. And Joshua fell on his face to the earth and worshipped and said to him, What does my Lord bid his servant? And the commander of the Lord's army said to Joshua, Put off your shoes from your feet, for the place where you stand is holy. And Joshua did so.
Let us wisdom.
The reading is from Exodus.
Let us attend.
And they moved on from Succoth and encamped at Etham and on the edge of the wilderness. And the Lord went before them by day in a pillar of cloud to lead them along the way, and by night in a pillar of fire to give them light, that they might travel by day and by night. The pillar of the cloud by day and the pillar of fire by night did not depart from before the people. Then the Lord said to Moses, Tell the people of Israel to turn back and encamp in front of Pi Hahiroth, between Migdol and the sea, in front of Baal Zephon, and you shall encamp over against it by the sea. For the Pharaoh will say of the people of Israel, They are entangled in the land, the wilderness has shut them in, and I will harden Pharaoh's heart, and he will pursue them, and I will give glory over Pharaoh and all his hosts, and the Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord. And they did so. When the king of Egypt was told that the people had fled, the mind of Pharaoh and his servants was changed toward the people, and they said, What is this we have done, that we have let Israel go from serving us? So he made ready his chariot and took his army with him, and took 600 picked chariots and all the other chariots in Egypt, and all the officers over all of them. And the Lord hardened the heart of Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, And he pursued the people of Israel as they went forth defiantly. The Egyptians pursued them, all Pharaoh's horses and chariots and his horsemen and his army, and overtook them and camped at the sea by Pi-Hahiroth in front of Baal Zephon. When Pharaoh drew near, the people of Israel lifted up their eyes, and behold, the Egyptians were marching after them, and they were in great fear. And the people of Israel cried out to the Lord, and they said to Moses, "Is it because there were no graves in Egypt that you have taken us away to die in the wilderness? What have you done to us in bringing us out of Egypt? Is not this what we said to you in Egypt? Let us alone and let us serve the Egyptians. For it would have been better for us to serve the Egyptians than to die in the wilderness." And Moses said to the people, "Fear not, stand firm, and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will work for you today. For the Egyptians whom you see today, you shall never see again. The Lord will fight for you, and you only have to be still." The Lord said to Moses, "Why do you cry after me? Tell the people of Israel to go forward. Lift up your rod and stretch out your hand over the sea and divide it, that the people of Israel may go on dry ground through the sea. And I will harden the hearts of the Egyptians, so that they shall go in after them, and I will get glory over Pharaoh and all his hosts, his chariots and his horsemen. And the Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord, when I have gotten glory over Pharaoh, his chariots, and his horsemen." Then the angel of God went before the host of Israel, moved and went behind them. And the pillar of cloud moved from before them and stood behind them, coming between the host of Egypt and the host of Israel. And there was a cloud and the darkness, and the night passed without one coming near one another all night. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the Lord drove back the sea by a strong east wind all night, and made the sea dry land, and the waters were divided. And the people of Israel went into the midst of the sea on dry ground, the waters being a wall to them on their right hand and on their left. The Egyptians pursued and went after them into the midst of the sea, all Pharaoh's horses, his chariots, and his horsemen. And in the morning watch, the Lord... In the morning watch, the Lord of the pillar of fire and of cloud looked down upon the host of the Egyptians and discomfited the host of the Egyptians, clogging their chariot wheels so that they drove heavily. And the Egyptians said, "Let us flee from before Israel, for the Lord fights for them against the Egyptians." Then the Lord said to Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the sea, that the waters may come back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots, upon their horsemen." So Moses stretched forth his hand over the sea, and the sea returned to its wonted flow when the morning appeared, and the Egyptians fled into it, and the Lord routed the Egyptians in the midst of the sea. The waters returned and covered the chariots and the horsemen and all the host of Pharaoh that had followed them into the sea, not so much as one of them remained. But the people of Israel walked on dry ground through the sea, the waters being a wall to them on their right hand and on their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel that day from the hand of the Egyptians. And Israel saw the Egyptians dead upon the seashore. And Israel saw the great work which the Lord did against the Egyptians. And the people feared the Lord, and they believed in the Lord and in his servant Moses. Then Moses and the children of Israel sang a song to the Lord and spoke, saying, "Let us sing to the Lord. Greatness of thy majesty. Thou hast overthrown their adversary, thy adversaries, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us sing unto the Lord, the water stood like a wall, the deeps congealed in the hearts of the sea. Let us sing unto the Lord.
Lord, gloriously has he been glorified.
Yes, I will pursue and I will overtake. I will divide the spoil, I will satisfy my soul. I will destroy my with my sword, and shall have dominion. Let us sing unto the Lord. Let us send thy spirit in the sea, cover them. They sank us, led in the mighty waters. Let us sing unto the Lord.
Lord, gloriously has he been glorified.
Who is like the Lord among the gods, who is like thee glorified in holiness. Marvelous in glory, doing wonders. Let us sing unto the Lord. Let us stretch out thy right hand, and the earth swallowed them. Thou hast led them in righteousness. In thy righteousness, the people whom thou hast redeemed. Let us sing unto the Lord.
Lord, gloriously has he been glorified.
The shores of Eden fish made, the leaders of God, trembling seizes them. All the inhabitants of Canaan have melted away. Let us sing unto the Lord. Let trembling and fear fall upon them because of thy greatness of thy arm. Let them become a stone. Let us sing unto the Lord.
Lord, gloriously has he been glorified.
Let us sing unto the Lord. Thou wilt bring them in and plant them on thy mountain, the place, O Lord, which thou hast made for thy abode, the sanctuary, O Lord, which thy hands have made ready. Let us sing unto the Lord.
Lord, gloriously has he been glorified.
Thou shalt reign forever and ever, for when the horse of the Pharaoh and with his chariots and horsemen went into the sea, the Lord brought back the waters of the sea upon them, but the children of Israel walked on dry ground in the midst of the sea. Let us sing unto the Lord.
Lord, gloriously has he been glorified.
Glory to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Let us sing unto the Lord.
Lord, gloriously has he been glorified.
Prophecy of Zephaniah.
Let us attend.
Thus says the Lord, wait for me for the day when I arise as a witness, for my decision is to gather nations, to assemble kingdoms, to pour out upon them my indignation, all the heat of my anger, for in the fire of my jealous wrath all the earth shall be consumed. Yea, at that time I will change the speech of the peoples to a pure speech, that all of them may call on the name of the Lord and serve him with one accord. From beyond the rivers of Ethiopia, my suppliants, the daughter of my dispersed ones, shall bring my offering. On that day you shall not be put to shame because of the deeds by which you have rebelled against me. For then I will remove from your midst your proudly exultant ones, and you shall no longer be haughty in my holy mountain. For I will leave in the midst of you a people humble and lowly. They shall seek refuge in the name of the Lord, those who are left in Israel. They shall do no wrong and utter no lies, nor shall there be found in their mouth a deceitful tongue. For they shall pasture and lie down, and none shall make them afraid. Sing aloud, O daughter of Zion, shout, O Israel, rejoice and exult with all your heart, O daughter of Jerusalem. The Lord has taken away the judgments against you. He has cast out your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord is in your midst. You shall see evil no more.
Wisdom.
The reading is from the third book of Kings.
Let us attend.
Then the word of the Lord came to Elijah, saying, arise, go to Zarephath, which belongs to Sidon, and dwell there. Behold, I have commanded a widow there to feed you. So he arose and went to Zarephath, and when he came to the gate of the city, behold, a widow was there gathering sticks. And he called to her and said, bring me a little water in a vessel that I may drink. And as she was going to bring it, he called to her and said, bring me a morsel of bread in your hand. And she said, as the Lord your God lives, I have nothing baked, only a handful of meal in a jar and a little oil in a cruse. And now I am gathering a couple of sticks that I may go in and prepare it for myself and my son, that we may eat it and die. And Elijah said to her, fear not, go and do as you have said, but first make me a little cake of it and bring it to me, and afterward make for yourself and your son. For thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, the jar of meal shall not be spent, and the cruse of oil shall not fail, until the day that the Lord sends rain upon the earth. And she went and did as Elijah said, and she and he and her household ate for many days. The jar of meal was not spent, neither did the cruse of oil fail, according to the word of the Lord, which he spoke by Elijah. After this, the son of the woman, the mistress of the house, became ill, and his illness was so severe that there was no breath left in him. And she said to Elijah, what have you against me, O man of God? You have come to me to bring my sin to remembrance and to cause the death of my son. And he said to her, give me your son. And he took him from her bosom and carried him up into the upper chamber where he lodged and laid him upon his own bed. And he cried to the Lord, O Lord my God, hast thou brought calamity even upon the widow with whom I sojourn by slaying her son? Then he stretched himself upon the child 3 times and cried to the Lord, O Lord my God, let this child's soul come into him again. And the Lord hearkened to the voice of Elijah, and the soul of the child came into him again, and he revived. And Elijah took the child and brought him down from the upper chamber into the house and delivered him to his mother. And Elijah said, see, your son lives. And the woman said to Elijah, now I know that you are a man of God, and that the word of the Lord in your mouth is true.
Wisdom.
The reading is from the prophecy of Isaiah.
Let us attend.
My soul shall rejoice in the Lord, for he has clothed me with the garment of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness, as a bridegroom decks himself with a garland, and as a bride adorns herself with jewels. For as the earth brings forth its shoots, and as the garden causes what is sown in it to spring up, so the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to spring forth before all the nations. For Zion's sake I will not keep silent, and for Jerusalem's sake I will not rest, until her vindication goes forth as brightness, and her salvation as a burning torch. The nations shall see your vindication, and all the kings your glory. And you shall be called by a new name, which the mouth of the Lord will give. You shall be a crown of beauty in the hand of the Lord, and a royal diadem in the hand of your God. You shall no more be termed forsaken, and your land shall no more be turned desolate, but you shall be called, my delight is in her, and your land married. For the Lord delights in you, and your land shall be married. For as a young man marries a virgin, so shall your sons marry you. And as the bridegroom rejoices over the bride, so shall your God rejoice over you.
Wisdom.
The reading is from the book of Genesis.
Let us attend.
After these things, God tested Abraham and said to him, Abraham, and he said, here am I. He said, take your son, your only son, Isaac, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah, and offer him there as a burnt offering upon one of the mountains of which I shall tell you. So Abraham rose early in the morning, saddled his ass, and took 2 of his young men with him, and his son Isaac. And he cut the wood for the burnt offering, and arose and went to the place of which God had told him. On the 3rd day, Abraham lifted up his eyes and saw the places afar off. Then Abraham said to his young men, stay here with the ass. I and the lad will go yonder and worship and come again to you. And Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering and laid it on Isaac his son. And he took in his hand the fire and the knife. So they went, both of them together. And Isaac said to his father Abraham, my father. And he said, here am I, my son. He said, behold the fire and the wood, but where is the lamb for a burnt offering? Abraham said, God will provide himself the lamb for a burnt offering, my son. So they went, both of them, together. When they came to the place of which God had told them, Abraham built an altar there, and laid the wood in order, and bound Isaac his son, and laid him on the altar upon the wood. Then Abraham put forth his hand and took the knife to slay his son. But the angel of the Lord called to him from the heaven and said, Abraham, Abraham. And he said, Here am I. He said, Do not lay your hand on the lad or do anything to him, for now I know that you fear God, seeing you have not withheld your son, your only son, from me. And Abraham lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, behind him was a ram caught in a thicket by his own horns. And Abraham went and took the ram and offered it up as a burnt offering instead of his son. So Abraham called the name of that place, The Lord Has Seen, as it is said to this day, On the mount the Lord was seen. And the angel of the Lord called to Abraham a second time from heaven and said, By myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will indeed bless you, and I will multiply your descendants as the stars of heaven and as the sand which is on the seashore. And your descendants shall possess the gate of their enemies, and by your descendants shall all the nations of the earth bless themselves because you have obeyed my voice.
Wisdom.
The reading is from the prophecy of Isaiah.
Let us attend.
The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me because the Lord has anointed me to bring good tidings to the afflicted. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to those who are bound, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to grant it to those who mourn in Zion, to give them a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the mantle of praise instead of a faint spirit, that they may be called oaks of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that he may be glorified. They shall build up the ancient ruins, they shall raise up the former devastations. They shall repair the ruined cities, the devastations of many generations. Aliens shall stand and feed your flocks. Foreigners shall be your plowmen and your vine dressers. But you shall be called the priests of the Lord. Men shall speak of you as the ministers of our God. You shall eat the wealth of the nations, and in their riches you shall glory. Instead of your shame, you shall have a double portion. Instead of dishonor, you shall rejoice in your lot. Therefore, in your land, you shall possess a double portion. Yours shall be everlasting joy. For I, the Lord, love justice. I hate robbery and wrong. I will faithfully give them their recompense, and I will make an everlasting covenant with them. Their descendants shall be known among the nations, and their offspring in the midst of the peoples. All who see them shall acknowledge them, that they are a people whom the Lord has blessed, and they shall greatly rejoice in the Lord.
Wisdom.
The readings from the fourth book of Kings.
Let us attend.
One day Elisha went to Shunem, where a wealthy woman lived, to urge him to eat some food. So whenever he passed that way, he would turn in there to eat food, and she said to her husband, Behold now, I perceive that this is a holy man of God, who is continually passing our way. Let us make a small roof chamber with walls and put there for him a bed, a table, a chair, and a lamp, so that whenever he comes to us, he can go in there. One day he came there, and he turned into the chamber and rested there. And he said to Gehazi, his servant, Call this Shunammite. When he had called her, she stood before him, and he said to him, Say now to her, See, you have taken all this trouble for us. What is to be done for you? Would you have a word spoken on your behalf to the king or to the commander of the army? She answered, I dwell among my own people. And he said, What then is to be done for her? Gehazi answered, Well, she has no son, and her husband is old. He said, Call her. And when he had called her, she stood in the doorway. And he said, At this season, when the times come around, you shall embrace a son. And she said, No, my lord, O man of God, do not lie to your maidservant. But the woman conceived, and she bore a son about that time the following spring, as Elisha had said to her. When the child had grown, he went out one day to his father among the reapers. And he said to his father, Oh, my head, my head. The father said to his servant, Carry him to his mother. And when he had lifted him and brought him to his mother, the child sat on her lap till noon, and then he died. And she went up and laid him on the bed of the man of God, and shut the door upon him, and went out. Then she called to her husband and said, Send me one of the servants and one of the asses, that I may quickly go to the man of God and come back again. And he said, Why will you go to him today? It is neither new moon nor Sabbath. She said, It will be well. Then she saddled the ass and said to her servant, Urge the beast on, do not slacken the pace for me unless I tell you. So she set out and came to the man of God at Mount Carmel. When the man of God saw her coming, he said to Gehazi, his servant, Look, yonder is the Shunammite. Run at once to meet her and say to her, Is it well with you? Is it well with your husband? Is it well with the child? And she answered, It is well. And when she came to the mountain to the man of God, she caught hold of his feet, and Gehazi came to thrust her away. But the man of God said, Let her alone, for she is in bitter distress, and the Lord has hidden it from me and has not told me. Then she said, Did I ask my Lord for a son? Did I not say, Do not deceive me? He said to Gehazi, Gird up your loins and take my staff in your hand and go. If you meet anyone, do not salute him. And if anyone salutes you, do not reply, and lay my staff upon the face of the child. Then the mother of the child said, As the Lord lives and as you yourself live, I will not leave you. So he arose and followed her. Gehazi went on ahead and laid the staff upon the face of the child, but there was no sound or sign of life. Therefore he returned to meet him and told him, The child is not awake. When Elisha came into the house, he saw the child lying dead on his bed. So he went in and shut the door upon the two of them, and prayed to the Lord. Then he went up and lay upon the child, putting his mouth upon his mouth, his eyes upon his eyes, and his hands upon his hands. And as he stretched himself upon him, the flesh of the child became warm. Then he got up again and walked once to and fro in the house, and went up and stretched himself upon him. The child sneezed 7 times, and the child opened his eyes. Then he summoned Gehazi and said, Call this Shunammite. So he called her, and when she came to him, he said, Take up your son. She came and fell at his feet, bowing to the ground. Then she took up her son and went out.
Wisdom.
Reading from the prophecy of Isaiah.
Let us attend.
Thus says the Lord, Where is he who brought up out of the sea the shepherd of his sheep? Where is he who put in the midst of them his Holy Spirit, who caused his glorious arm to go at the right hand of Moses, who divided the water before them, to make for himself an everlasting name, who led them through the depths? Like a horse in the desert they did not stumble, like cattle that go down into the valley, the Spirit of the Lord gave them rest. So thou didst lead thy people to make for thyself a glorious name. Look down from heaven and see, from thy holy and glorious habitation, where are thy zeal and thy might? The yearning of thy heart and thy compassion are withheld from me. For thou art our father, though Abraham does not know us and Israel does not acknowledge us. Thou, O Lord, art our Father, our Redeemer from of old is thy name. O Lord, why dost thou make us err from thy ways, and harden our heart so that we fear thee not? Return for the sake of thy servants, the tribes of thy heritage. Thy holy people possess thy sanctuary a little while. Our adversaries have trodden it down. We have become like those over whom thou hast never ruled, like those who are not called by thy name. Oh, that thou wouldst rend the heavens and come down, that the mountains might quake at thy presence, as when fire kindles brushwood and the fire causes water to boil, to make thy name known to thine adversaries, and that the nations might tremble at thy presence. When thou didst terrible things which we looked not for, thou camest down, the mountains quaked at thy presence. From of old no one has heard or perceived by the ear, no eye has seen a God besides thee, who works for those who wait for him. Thou madest him that joyfully works righteousness, those that remember thee in thy ways.
Wisdom.
The reading from the prophecy of Jeremiah.
Let us attend.
Thus says the Lord, Behold, the days are when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah, not like the covenant which I made with their fathers when I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt, my covenant which they broke, though I was their husband, says the Lord. But this is the covenant which I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will put my law within them, and I will write it upon their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. And no longer shall each man teach his neighbor and each his brother, saying, Know the Lord, for they shall all know me, from the least of them to the greatest, says the Lord. For I will forgive their iniquity, and I will remember their sin no more.
Wisdom.
The reading is from the prophecy of Daniel.
Let us attend.
In his 18th year, King Nebuchadnezzar made an image of gold, whose height was 60 cubits and its breadth 6 cubits. He set it up on the plain of Dura in the province of Babylon. Then King Nebuchadnezzar sent to assemble the satraps, the prefects, and the governors, the counselors, the treasurers, the justices, the magistrates, and all the officials of the provinces to come to the dedication of the image which King Nebuchadnezzar had set up. Then the satraps, the prefects, and the governors, the counselors, the treasurers, the justices, the magistrates, and all the officials of the provinces were assembled for the dedication of the image that King Nebuchadnezzar had set up. And they stood before the image that Nebuchadnezzar had set up. And the herald proclaimed aloud, You are commanded, O peoples, nations, and languages, that when you hear the sound of the horn, pipe, lyre, trigon, harp, bagpipe, and every kind of music, you are to fall down and worship the golden image that King Nebuchadnezzar has set up. And whoever does not fall down and worship shall immediately be cast into a burning fiery furnace. Therefore, as soon as all the people heard the sound of the horn, pipe, lyre, trigon, harp, bagpipe, and every kind of music, all the peoples, nations, and languages fell down and worshiped the golden image which King Nebuchadnezzar had set up. Therefore, at that time, certain Chaldeans came forward and maliciously accused the Jews. They said to King Nebuchadnezzar, O king, live forever. You, O king, have made a decree that every man who hears the sound of the horn, pipe, lyre, trigon, harp, bagpipe, and every kind of music shall fall down and worship the golden image, and whoever does not fall down and worship shall be cast into a burning fiery furnace. There are certain Jews whom you have appointed over the affairs of the province of Babylon, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. These men, O king, pay no heed to you. They do not serve your gods or worship the golden image which you have set up. Then Nebuchadnezzar, in furious rage, commanded that Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego be brought. When they brought these men before the king, Nebuchadnezzar said to them, Is it true, O Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, that you do not serve my gods or worship the golden image which I have set up? Now, if you are ready, when you hear the sound of the horn, pipe, lyre, trigon, harp, bagpipe, and every kind of music, to fall down and worship the image which I have made, well and good. But if you do not worship, you shall immediately be cast into a burning fiery furnace. And who is the God that will deliver you out of my hands? Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered the king, O Nebuchadnezzar, we have no need to answer you in this matter. If it be so, our God, whom we serve, is in the heavens, able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us out of your hand, O king. But if not, be it known to you, O king, that we will not serve your gods or worship the golden image which you have set up. Then Nebuchadnezzar was full of fury, and the expression of his face was changed against Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. He ordered the furnace heated 7 times more than it was wont to be heated, and he ordered certain mighty men of his army to bind Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, and to cast them into the burning fiery furnace. Then these men were bound in their mantles, their tunics, their hats, and their other garments, and they were cast into the burning fiery furnace. Because the king's order was strict and the furnace very hot, the flame of the fire slew those men who took up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And these 3 men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, fell bound into the burning fiery furnace. And they walked about in the midst of the flames, singing hymns to God and blessing the Lord. Then Azariah stood and offered this prayer in the midst of the fire. He opened his mouth and he said,
Blessed art thou, O Lord God of our fathers, and worthy of praise, and thy name is glorified forever. For thou art just in all that thou hast done for us, and for all the work, and all thy works are true, and thy ways right, and all thy judgments are truth. Thou hast executed true judgments in all that thou hast brought upon us and upon Jerusalem, the holy city of our fathers, for in truth and justice thou hast brought all this upon us because of our sins. For we have sinfully and lawlessly departed from thee, and have sinned in all things, and have not obeyed thy commandments. We have not observed them, nor done them, as thou hast commanded that it might go well with us. So all that thou hast brought upon us, and all that thou hast done to us, thou hast done in true judgment. Thou hast given us into the hands of lawless enemies, most hateful rebels, and into an unjust king, the most wicked in all the world. And now we cannot open our mouths. Shame and disgrace have befallen thy servants and thy worshippers. For thy name's sake, do not give us up utterly, and do not break thy covenant, and do not withdraw thy mercy from us, for the sake of Abraham, thy beloved, and for the sake of Isaac, thy servant, and Israel, thy holy one, to whom thou hast promised to make their descendants as many as the stars of heaven, and as the sand on the shore of the sea. For we, O Lord, have become fewer than any nation, and are brought low this day in all the world because of our sins. At this time there is no prince or prophet or leader, no burnt offering or sacrifice or oblation or incense, no place to make an offering before thee or to find mercy. Yet with a contrite heart and a humble spirit may we be accepted, as though it were with burnt offerings of rams and bulls, and with tens of thousands of fat lambs. Such may be our sacrifice in thy sight this day, and may we wholly follow thee, for there will be no shame for those who trust in thee. And now with all our heart we follow thee, we fear thee, and we seek thy face. Do not put us to shame, but deal with us in thy forbearance and in thy abundant mercy. Deliver us in accordance with thy marvelous works, and give glory to thy name, O Lord. Let all who do harm to thy servants be put to shame. Let them be disgraced and deprived of power and dominion, and let their strength be broken. Let them know that thou art the Lord, the only God, glorious over all the world.
Now the king's servants who threw them in did not cease feeding the furnace fires with naphtha, pitch, tow, and brush. And the flame streamed out above the furnace 49 cubits, and it broke through and burned those of the Chaldeans whom it caught about in the furnace. But the angel of the Lord came down into the furnace to be with Azariah and his companions, and drove the fiery flame out of the furnace, and made the midst of the furnace like a moist whistling wind, so that the fire did not touch them at all, or hurt or trouble them. Then the three, as with one mouth, praised and glorified and blessed God in the furnace, saying, Blessed art thou, O Lord God of our fathers, and to be praised and highly exalted forever. And blessed is thy glorious holy name, and to be highly praised and highly exalted forever. Blessed art thou in the temple of thy holy glory, and to be extolled and highly glorified forever. Blessed art thou who sittest upon cherubim and lookest upon the deeps, and to be praised and highly exalted forever. Blessed art thou upon the throne of thy kingdom, and to be extolled and highly exalted forever. Blessed art thou in the firmament of heaven, and to be sung and glorified forever.
Praise the Lord, sing and exalt him throughout all the ages.
Bless the Lord, all works of the Lord. Bless the Lord, you heavens. Bless the Lord, you angels of the Lord.
Praise the Lord, sing and exalt him throughout all the ages.
Bless the Lord, all watchers above the heaven. Bless the Lord, all powers.
Praise the Lord, sing and exalt him throughout all the ages.
Bless the Lord, sun and moon. Bless the Lord, stars and heaven.
Praise the Lord, sing and exalt him throughout all the ages.
Bless the Lord, all rain and dew. Bless the Lord, all winds.
Praise the Lord, sing and exalt him throughout all the ages.
Bless the Lord, fire and heat. Bless the Lord, winter cold and summer heat. Bless the Lord, dews and snows.
Praise the Lord, sing and exalt him throughout all the ages.
Bless the Lord, nights and days. Bless the Lord, light Bless the Lord, lightnings and clouds.
Praise the Lord, sing and exalt him throughout all the ages.
Bless the earth, bless the Lord, bless the Lord, mountains and hills, bless the Lord, all things that grow upon the earth.
Praise the Lord, sing and exalt him throughout all the ages.
Bless the Lord, you springs, bless the Lord, seas and rivers, bless the Lord, you whales and all creatures that move in the waters.
Praise the Lord, sing and exalt him throughout all the ages.
Of the air, bless the Lord, all beasts and cattle.
Praise the Lord, sing and exalt him throughout all the ages.
Bless the Lord, you sons of men, bless the Lord, O Israel, bless the Lord, you priests of the Lord, bless the Lord, you servants of the Lord.
Praise the Lord, sing and exalt him throughout all the ages.
Spirits and souls of the righteous, bless the Lord, you who are holy and humble in heart.
Praise the Lord, sing and exalt him throughout all the ages.
Bless the Lord, Ananiah, Azariah, and Mishael.
Praise the Lord, sing and exalt him throughout all the ages.
Bless the Lord, apostles, prophets, and martyrs of the Lord.
Oh.
Let us attend. Peace be unto all.
And with your spirit.
Wisdom.
The prokimenon in the fifth tone. Let all the earth worship thee and praise thee. Let it praise thy name, O Most High.
Let all the earth worship thee and praise thee. Let it praise thy name.
Yes. Now after the Sabbath,
as the first day of the week began to dawn, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to see the tomb. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat upon it. His countenance was like lightning, and his clothes as white as snow. And the guards shook for fear of him, and he became like dead men. But the angel answered and said to the women, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you seek Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he is risen, as he said, 'Come see the place where the Lord lay.' And go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead, and indeed he is going before you into Galilee. There you will see him. Behold, I have told you." So they went out quickly from the tomb with fear and great joy, and ran to bring his disciples word. And they went to tell his disciples, behold, Jesus met them, saying, "Rejoice." Then the 11 disciples went away into Galilee to the mountain which Jesus had appointed for them. When he saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and spoke to them, saying, "All authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the age." He revealed himself through his death on the cross. On the cross, we did not just see all of God's glory pass by like Moses. No, we saw the King of Glory himself. We met God face to face, and the Word of God spoke a word, and he said, "It is finished." Jesus Christ completed the work of his Father, as he promised his disciples. He promised that he would make his Father known to them, and he did. And after that, Jesus gave up his spirit, the earth quaked, and now there is silence, the silence of the tomb. And that was the silence that we contemplated for the first half of our Vesperal Divine Liturgy. As Mother Christophora mentioned yesterday, this is one of those days where we have silence and we have great joy. So today, we sit in the midst of that silence, and we listened to all of the history of Israel. And I realize it was a very long history. There were 15 Old Testament readings, right? But in all of that history, what we learned about in light of seeing God face to face, we learned that all of the things in the Old Testament were shadows. Shadows of things that were to come. In the beginning, God created heaven and earth, and he created it in a good way. Everything was good. And we know that after that part of the creation story, at the end, on the seventh day, we know that God rested. And for the Jewish people, having a Sabbath is kind of like having the period at the end of a sentence, right? It's just after the entire sentence is crafted, after it's perfect, then you put that final mark on it, that period. And we know that God did that with creation, but today we realize this was only a shadow, because the real creation, the renewing of all of creation, was done in our Lord Jesus Christ. And so today, what does he do? He puts that final mark on what he's done, and he rests in the tomb. So it's in the silence of that tomb that we contemplate all of these things that have happened, now that we too have seen the face of God.
But it wasn't just the earthly creation that saw the face of God. Because we go on and we realize that Christ is in the tomb. And now, whenever we sang in the Lord I Call, we hear that hell itself cries out groaning. Because it too took a body, and it too met God face to face. So in our silence, we can hear hell groan, because Christ is victorious. So even in the silence of the tomb, even in all of the sadness that happened before and everything else, we realize that silence is the complete and utter presence of God. And it's there for us. And all those other things were shadows. And we realize, the funny thing about shadows is that you can't have a shadow in complete darkness. It's impossible. In order to have a shadow, you have to have light. And so now, even in the midst of the silence of that tomb, if we can see shadows, then we can see the light. And that light is shining from the tomb. So after all of this, after all the silence, after meeting God face to face, we meet God and we see light. Hell meets God, and it's abolished. So after that, we only have one other thing to say. We have one more word. Because in the gospel reading today, after another earthquake, there's another word, and that's the word of the angel. And what he says is, he is not here. He is not here in the tomb. He is risen. And of course, that is joyful news for all of us, right? And there's only one cross to bear with that joyful news. For some reason, the church has decided that we must still stay silent. So many times we're going to want to say the greeting. The greeting that we all know goes with these white robes and everything else. That joy is here. That joy is around us. That joy continues, even when the rest of the world doesn't even know that. And we want to say those words. But the church says, not yet. There must be a little bit more silence. So in just a moment, instead of singing the cherubic hymn, we will sing, "Let all mortal flesh keep silent." And then we will keep silent. And as I take that chalice and that discus and I put it on the tomb of Christ, the tomb that we've now placed on the altar, I will say a particular prayer. Bearing life more fruitful than paradise, brighter than any royal chamber, thy tomb of Christ has become the fountain of our resurrection. And in that act, in the act of us placing all of those things on there, Christ then will come to us and he will feed us with his Eucharist. So I agree, it is hard. We must still wait in the silence, right? But now God can give us hope. He can feed us with his body and blood so that hopefully we can all be strengthened. We can be strengthened and come back and we can meet the bridegroom. All the way at the beginning of Holy Week, we announced we were waiting for the bridegroom. And the bridegroom is coming. We know that Christ is risen. We know that we can now enter the marriage, the wedding feast, and he is coming. So let us pray that all of us have the strength to be able to meet our Lord at his holy Pascha and begin the never-ending day of his resurrection. Amen.
Let us say with all our soul and with all our mind, let us sing.
O Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, Almighty, the God of our fathers, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to thy great goodness, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy. Again, we pray for his beatitude, our Metropolitan Tifa, and for our Archbishop Nathaniel, for priests, deacons, and all other clergy, and all the brethren in Christ, and for our brethren in
Christ.
Again, we pray for the blessed and ever memorable Holy Orthodox Patriarchs, and for the blessed and ever memorable founders of this Holy House, especially for the newly departed, and for all those departed before us, especially the newly departed, the Archpriest Angelo, the for Christopher, Wolfgang, Wolfgang, Adrian, Brendan, Gina, Olga, Helen, Mary, for Matthew, Essie, James, Virginia, Lydia, Aurora, Despina, James, Daniel, and Gloria, and for all the Orthodox Christians departed here and in all the world. Again, we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, and visitation for the servants of God, Archpriest Ian, the priest Paul, the Archpriest Theodore, the priest John, the priest Gregory, for Stephen, Stasis, Maria, Daniel, Costa, Hope, Robert, Anna, for James, Paul, Olga, and Alexander, for Daria, Aquilina, Eileen, Stephen, Constantine, Karina, for Simeon, Irina, Leo, Alexander, Timothy, for Tara, Melissa, for Valerie, and the child George, for Kristen, and for Nicole, and for the pardon and remission of their sins. Again, we pray for those who bring offerings and do good works in this holy and all venerable house, for those who labor, those who sing, and for all the people here present who await thy great and rich mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord.
For thou art a merciful God, and lovest mankind, and unto thee be ascribed glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Pray to the Lord your catechumens. Let us the faithful pray for the catechumens, that the Lord may have mercy on them. That we may teach them the word of truth, that we may reveal to them the gospel of righteousness, that we may unite them to His holy Catholic Apostolic Church. Help them, save them, have mercy on them, and keep them, O God, by thy grace. Bow your heads unto the Lord, you catechumens. O Lord our God, who dwellest on high and regardest the humble of our heart, who has sent forth the salvation for the race of men, and for the race of men, that only begotten Son, and God our Lord Jesus Christ, look down upon thy servants, the catechumens, especially for Eric and Catherine, who are to be chrismated this day, who have bowed their necks before thee, make them worthy in due time of the laver of regeneration, the remission of sins, and the robe of incorruption. Unite them in the Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, and number them with thy chosen flock, that with us they may glorify the honorable and majestic name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. All catechumens depart, depart, catechumens, all that are catechumens depart, let no catechumen remain. Let us, the faithful, again and again in peace pray unto the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Wisdom, for unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Wisdom, that guarded always by thy might, we may ascribe glory unto thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Christ our God.
Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with thine all holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be unto all.
And to your spirit.
Let us love one another, that with one mind we may confess.
Thank you.
him the salvation of regeneration in thy Christ himself. For thou hast not turned thyself away forever from thy creature whom thou hast made, O good one, nor didst thou forget the work of thy hands. Through the tender compassion of thy mercy thou hast visited him in various ways, that hast sent prophets, that hast performed mighty works by thy saints, who in every generation were well pleasing to thee. Thou dost speak to us by the mouth of thy servants, the prophets, foretelling to us the salvation which was to come. Thou dost give to us a law as a help. Thou dost appoint angels as guardians. And when the fullness of time had come, thou dost speak to us through thy Son himself, by whom thou dost also make the ages, who being the radiance of thy glory and the image of thy person, upholding all things by the word of his power, thought it not robbery to be equal to thee, the God and Father. He was God before the ages, yet he appeared on earth and lived among men, becoming incarnate of a holy virgin. He emptied himself, taking the form of a servant, being likened to the body of our lowliness, that he might liken us to the image of his glory. For as by man sin entered into the world, and by sin death, so it pleased thine only begotten Son, who is in the bosom of thee, the God and Father, who was born of a woman, the holy Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, who was born under the law to condemn sin in his flesh, so that those who were dead in Adam might be made alive in thy Christ himself. He lived in this world and gave us the commandments of salvation, releasing us from the delusion of idolatry. He brought us the knowledge of thee, the true God and Father. He obtained us for his own chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation. Having cleansed us in water and sanctified us with the Holy Spirit, he gave himself as a ransom to death, in which we were held captive, sold under sin, descending through the cross into hell, that he might fill all things with himself. He loosed the pangs of death. He arose on the third day, having made for all flesh a path to the resurrection from the dead, since it was not possible for the author of life to be a victim of corruption. So he became the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep, the firstborn of the dead, that he might himself truly be the first in all things. Ascending into heaven, he sat down at the right hand of thy majesty on high, and he will come to render to every man according to his works. And as memorials of the saving passion, he has left us these things which we have set forth according to his command. For when he was about to go forth to his voluntary and ever memorable and life-creating death, in the night in which he gave himself up for the life of the world, he took bread in his holy and pure hands, and having shown it to thee, the God and Father, having given thanks, blessed it, and hallowed it, and broken it, he gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you for the remission of sins. Likewise, he took the cup of the fruit of the vine, and having mingled it and given thanks, he blessed it and hallowed it. He gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, Drink of it, all of you. This is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this in remembrance of me, for as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim my death, you confess my resurrection. Therefore we also, O Master, remembering his saving passion and life-creating cross, his three-day burial and resurrection from the dead, his ascension into heaven, and his sitting at the right hand of thee, the God and Father, and his glorious and awesome second coming. Thine own, we offer unto thee, on behalf of all and for all.
Thank you.
thy sinful and unworthy servants whom thou hast permitted to serve at the holy altar, because of our own, not because of our own righteousness, for we have done nothing good upon the earth, but because of thy mercy and compassions, which thou hast so richly poured out upon us, we now dare to approach thy holy altar, and offering thee the antitypes of the holy body and blood of thy Christ, we pray thee and call upon thee, O Holy of Holies, that by the favor of the goodness of thy Holy Spirit, that it may come upon them, us, and upon these gifts now offered, to bless, to hallow, and to show this bread to be the precious body of thy Christ, of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And this cup to be the precious blood of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Shed for the life of the world. Amen. Making the change by the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
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 Amen. And unite all of us one to another, we become partakers of the one bread and cup, and the communion of the Holy Spirit. Grant that none of us may partake of the holy body and blood of thy Christ for judgment or condemnation. Instead, may we find mercy and grace with all the saints and for all the ages have been well pleasing to the ancestors, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, teachers, and every righteous spirit made perfect in faith. Especially for our most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary. Remember, O Lord, those who are in the deserts, mountains, caverns, and pits of the earth. Remember, O Lord, those who live in chastity and godliness, in austerity and holiness of life. Remember, O Lord, this country and all civil authorities. Grant them secure and lasting peace. Speak good things into their hearts concerning thy church and all thy people, that we in their tranquility may lead a calm and peaceful life in all godliness and sanctity. Remember, O Lord, every principality and authority, our brothers who serve in the government and the armed forces. Preserve the good in thy goodness, and make the evil be good in thy, by thy goodness. Remember, O Lord, the people here present, and also those who are absent in honorable places. Have mercy on them and on us according to the multitude of thy mercies. Fill their treasuries with every good thing. Preserve their marriages in peace and harmony. Raise the infants, guide the young, support the aged, encourage the faint-hearted. Reunite the separated. Lead back those who are in error, and join them to thy holy Catholic and apostolic church. Free those who are held captive by unclean spirits. Sail with those who sail. Travel with those who travel by land and by air. Defend the widows. Protect the orphans. Free the captives. Heal the sick. Remember, O Lord, those who are in courts, in mines, in exile, in harsh labor, and those in any kind of affliction, necessity, or distress. Remember, O Lord, our God, all those who entreat thy great loving kindness, those who love us and those who hate us, those who have asked us to pray for them and worthy though we be. And remember all thy people, O Lord, our God. Pour out thy rich mercy upon all of them, granting them all the petitions which are for their salvation. And remember thyself, O God, all those whom thou hast not, we have not remembered through ignorance, forgetfulness, or the multitude of names, since thou knowest the name and age of each, even from his mother's womb. For thou, O Lord, art the helper of the helpless, the hope of the hopeless, the savior of the bestormed, the haven of the voyager, the physician of the sick.
Be all things to all men, O thou who knowest each man and his request, his home, and his need. Deliver this holy habitation, O Lord, and every city and country from famine, plague, earthquake, flood, fire, sword, invasion by enemies, and from civil war. Among the first, O Lord, remember, O Lord, the Beatitude, the most blessed Tikhon, and his eminence, our Archbishop Nathaniel. Grant them for thy holy churches in peace, safety, honor, health, and length of days, rightly to divide the word of thy truth.
Remember all your people.
Rightly divide the word of thy truth. Remember, O Lord, my unworthiness also by the multitude of thy compassions. Forgive me my every transgression, both voluntary and involuntary. Because of my sins, do not withhold the grace of thy Holy Spirit from these gifts you set here. Remember, O Lord, the priest of the diaconate of Christ, and the word of the that none of us who stand about thy holy altar be put to confusion. Visit us with thy loving kindness, O Lord. Manifest thyself to us through thy rich compassions. Grant us seasonable and helpful weather. Send gentle showers upon the earth so that it may bear fruit. Bless the crown of the year with thy goodness. Prevent schisms among the churches. Pacify the ragings of the pagans. Quickly destroy the uprisings of Pharisees by the power of thy Holy Spirit. Receive us all into thy kingdom, showing us to be sons of the light and sons of the day. Grant us thy peace and thy love, O Lord God, for thou hast given all things to us. And grant that with one mouth and one heart we may praise thine all honorable and majestic name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and into ages of ages.
Amen.
And the mercies of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ be with all of you. Having remembered all the saints again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the precious gifts offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
And our God, who loves mankind, receiving them upon his holy, heavenly, and ideal altar as a sweet spiritual fragrance, will send down upon us in return his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
That the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord.
God, Lord.
An angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant it, O Lord.
Pardon and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant it, O Lord.
All things that are good and profitable for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant it, O Lord.
That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant it, O Lord.
A Christian ending to our life, painless, blameless, and peaceful, and if it be bent before the dread judgment seat of Christ, let us ask.
Grant it, O Lord.
Having asked for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God. God, the God of salvation, do thou teach us to thank thee worthily for the benefits which thou hast performed for us, and still performest with us. Having accepted these gifts, O our God, do thou purify us from every defilement of flesh and spirit, and teach us how to perfect our sanctification in thy fear, so that receiving a portion of thy holy things with a pure conscience, we may be united with the holy body and blood of thy Christ. Having received them worthily, may we have Christ dwelling in our hearts, and may we become the temple of thy Holy Spirit. Yea, O our God, let none of us be guilty of these thine awesome and heavenly mysteries, nor be infirm in soul and body by partaking of them unworthily, but enable us even to our last breath to receive a portion of thy holy things worthily, as a support on the road to eternal life and an acceptable defense at thy dread judgment seat of thy Christ, that we also, together with all the saints who through all the ages have been well pleasing to thee, may become partakers of thy eternal good things which thou hast prepared for those who love thee, O Lord. And make us worthy, O Master, that with holiness and without condemnation, we may dare to call on thee, the heavenly God, as Father, and to say,
Father.
thine is the kingdom, and thine is the power, and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be unto all.
And unto your spirit.
Let us bow our heads unto the Lord. God of every consolation, bless, sanctify, guard, strengthen, and confirm those who have bowed their heads to thee. Withdraw them from every evil deed, apply them to every good work, and make them worthy to partake without condemnation of these thy most pure and life-creating mysteries, for the remission of sins and for the communion of the Holy Spirit. Through the grace and compassion and love toward mankind of thine only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with thine all holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Attend, O Lord Jesus Christ, your heavenly grace, for you, from the good, that you have sanctified, so that this is the kind of the Father, the Lord, and 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 the Let us attend. The holy things are for the holy.
I believe, O Lord, and I confess that thou art truly the Christ, the Son of the living God, who camest into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the first. And I believe also that this is truly thine own most pure body, and that this is truly thine own precious blood. Therefore I pray thee, have mercy upon me, and forgive my transgressions, both voluntary and involuntary, of word and of deed, committed in knowledge or ignorance, and make me worthy to partake without condemnation of thy most pure mysteries, for the remission of my sins, and unto life everlasting. Amen. But thine is still suffer, O Son of God, accept me today as a communicant, for I will not speak of thy mystery to thine enemies. Neither like Judas will I give thee a kiss, but like the thief will I confess thee. Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom. May the communion of thy holy mysteries be neither to my judgment nor to my condemnation, O Lord, but to the healing of soul and body. Amen.
For
forgive me, mother, sisters, and brothers. Yes.
I just wanted to make more space for us in this area for people. It's okay. Thank you.
In the fear of God, with faith and love, draw near.
Thank you.
always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Do thou, O Master of all, grant that the communion of thy holy body and blood of thy Christ may be for us for a faith unashamed, a love unfeigned, an increase of wisdom, the healing of soul and body, the repelling of every adversary, the observing of thy commandments, and an acceptable defense at thy dread judgment seat of thy Christ. For thou art our sanctification, and unto thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Let us depart in peace.
In the name of the Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, who blessest those who bless thee, and sanctifiest those who trust in thee, save thy people and bless thine inheritance, preserve the fullness of thy church, sanctify those who love the beauty of thy house, glorify them in return by thy divine power, and forsake us not to put our hope in thee. Give peace to thy world, to thy churches, to thy priests, to all those in civil authority, and to all thy people. For every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from thee, the Father of lights. And unto thee we ascribe glory, thanksgiving, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord at this world, and forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
The blessing of the Lord be upon you through his grace and love for mankind, always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to thee, O Christ, our God and our hope. Glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
True God, through the prayers of his most pure mother, of the holy, glorious, and all audible apostles, our Father among the saints, Basil the Great, Archbishop of Caesarea in Cappadocia, whose liturgy we celebrate today, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is good and loveth mankind.
Amen.
Ways. This is a very profound service, of course, for everyone each year. And we thank Father Michael. It's very recently ordained, and we put him here through the mill. But he's doing very well, and thank you very much for serving us at this time, Father, and welcome you and your wife with us. And we welcome all of you this morning for being together. Just a word of explanation in the Byzantine Rite. The plashtonitsa, epitaphios, is taken to the altar at the end of the procession on Friday night during that service for the Mass of Praises. So it's only at a short time, a few hours in the afternoon in the Byzantine Rite typikon, as I understand it. And in the Russian Rite typikon, the plashtonitsa is left out Friday afternoon, on Friday night, Saturday until the nocturne, very late Saturday night, and then it's taken in. And we found for ourselves, we kind of had to make a little bit of a hybrid here at the service, but we found it works very well for all the responsibilities that we have and the shortcomings that we have. So we take it in during this service this morning, when we first hear the words, "Arise, O God, judge the earth, for to thee belong all the nations." And the priest picks up the shroud, the epitaphios from the tomb, and places it on the altar now for 40 days. So that's just a little explanation. We a number of reasons historically why we started to do that here in our monastery, but it makes it rather dramatic hearing that "Arise, O God," when you see that happen, and I kind of have to say I do appreciate it. So that's how we'll celebrate. Now the sisters will have this afternoon to remove the tomb and put the flowers around and everything, because it's too hard to do that at midnight. We don't have enough people. Speaking of midnight, it's 12 o'clock noon now, or a little bit after, so we have this nice half of the day for lots of things we want to do, but we will be serving a meal. We will be serving a meal in about 12:30, so in the meantime, if you want to have coffee and juice, you're welcome to do that. We won't ring any bells today because we wait for the resurrection bells tonight. So I won't be ringing my bell to make you quiet in the refectory, because you already know you have to be quiet. And we won't be ringing the bell when the food is done. We just have to come, okay? So that's how we're going to do it. But as I say, if you want to drink something in the meantime while Mother Galena's finishing the cooking, the rest of us will come at 12:30 for the meal together. Thank you. We'll venerate the cross now and have the prayers of thanksgiving.
Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee, O God, glory to thee, O God. I thank thee, O Lord, my God, for thou hast not rejected me a sinner, but hast made me worthy to be a partaker of thy holy things. I thank thee, for thou hast permitted me the unworthy to commune of thy most pure and heavenly gifts. But, O Master, who lovest mankind, for our sakes didst die and rise again, give us thus these awesome and life-creating mysteries for the good and sanctification of our souls and bodies. Let them be for the healing of soul and body, the repelling of every adversary, the illumining of the eyes of my heart, peace of my spiritual powers, a faith unashamed, a love unfeigned, the fulfilling of wisdom, the observing of thy commandments, the receiving of thy divine grace, and the attaining of thy kingdom. Preserved by them in thy hopefulness, may I always remember thy grace in them, not for myself alone, but for thee, our Master and Benefactor. May I pass from this life in the hope of eternal life, so remain in the everlasting rest, with the voice of those who feast is unceasing, and the gladness of those who behold the goodness of thy countenance is unending. For thou art the true desire, the ineffable joy of those who love thee, O Christ our God, and all creation sings thy praise forever. Amen.
O Master Christ our God, King of the ages, maker of all things, I thank thee for all the good things thou hast given me, especially for the communion with thy most pure and life-creating mysteries. I pray thee, O gracious love, fair man, preserve me under thy protection, beneath the shadow of thy wings, and enable me to give to my last breath to partake worthily with a pure conscience of thy holy things, for the remission of my sins and the life eternal. For thou art the bread of life, the fountain of holiness, the giver of all good. For to thee be ascribed glory, with the Father and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages and ages.
Freely thou hast given me thy
my body for my food, and thou art a fire consuming me unworthy. Consume me not, O my Creator, but instead enter into my members, my veins, my heart. Consume the thorns of my transgressions, cleanse my soul, and sanctify my reasonings. Make firm my knees and body, illumine my five senses. Nail me to the fear of thee, always protect, guard, and keep me from soul-destroying words and deeds. Cleanse me, purify me, and adorn me. Give me understanding and illumination. Show me to be a temple of thy one spirit and not the one of many sins. May every evil thing, every carnal passion, flee from me as from the fire, as I become thy tabernacle through communion. I offer thee as intercessors all the saints, the leaders of the bodiless host, thy forerunner, thy wise apostles, and thy pure and blameless mother. Accept their prayers and thy love, O my Christ, and make me thy servant, a child of light. For thou art the only sanctification and life of our souls, O good one, and to be our master and God, we ascribe glory day by day.
The Lord Jesus Christ, our God, let thy holy body be my eternal life, thy precious blood my remission of sins. Let this Eucharist be my joy, health, and gladness. Make me a sinner worthy to stand on the right hand of thy glory at thine awesome second coming, through the prayers of thy most pure mother and of all the saints. The most holy lady, Theotokos, the light of my darkened soul, my hope, my protection, my refuge, my rest, and my joy. I thank you, for you have permitted me, the unworthy, to be a partaker of the most pure body and precious blood of your Son. Give the light of understanding to the eyes of my heart, you that gave birth to the true light. Remind me, who am deadened by sin, you that gave birth to the fountain of immortality. Have mercy on me, O loving mother of the merciful God. Grant me compunction and contrition of heart, humility in my thoughts, and a release from the slavery of my own reasonings. And enable me, even to my last breath, to receive the sanctification of the most pure mysteries for the healing of soul and body. Grant me tears of repentance and confession that I may glorify you all the days of my life. For you are blessed and greatly glorified forever. Amen.
Lord, now let your servant depart in peace, according to the word, for mine eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people, a light to enlighten the Gentiles and the glory.